asked Mariah if she could stop by with East, one of our longtime pit bulls, while they were out on a walk so I could share some news with her.
So I had gotten a really good application in for a pit bull that was kind of medium in size, but they had specified, you know, do you have any medium-sized pit bulls that are tougher placements or don't really get looked at? And I said East.
She's never had a meet and greet, has she?
She's never gotten that far. She's never gotten a single application. If I've sent pictures to adopters of her, they don't even give her a second look. And it's okay, to each their own, and you know, some people fall in love with something different, and I don't hold that against anybody. It's just a dog that gets overlooked time and time again, and people don't realize this amazing personality she has. And we know that if somebody would just agree to meet her, that they would fall in love with her just like we have.
Is she getting a home?
Well, they're coming for a meet and greet to meet her. So we don't know until they meet her in person, but she was like, I want to meet East and only
East.
I
love this lady.
I know, me too.
I'm in love with her.
I was like, okay, just East then.
Those are the people that...
really special.
Some of these dogs would end up here their whole lives if it wasn't for people like
that. Just because of the way they look. If there's nothing like flashy about them, they get overlooked on the website.
East is one of the dogs that we assumed would be with us forever. We still try. But we just already had a place in our hearts where it's like, she's a lifer. So this was a huge, huge deal for East. She potentially is not gonna have to live with us.
The wife is actually a breast cancer survivor.
She wants an easier dog.
Yeah, an easier dog that's gonna be home with her all day, keeping her company. And clearly she's so sweet when she's like one-on-one with you inside.
Yeah, I'm sure that lady doesn't have a ton of energy.
But the one thing I definitely wanna work on with her is jumping and her jumping up on stuff.
Yeah, we'll do some training stuff after we
talk. Then I was trying to think of ways that we could spruce her up a little bit for her meet and greet, so.
Oh, the bandanas.
I thought we could
pick
out a fun bandana.
You want a bandana? Lizzie's just trying to go the extra mile in any way possible to guarantee that East has a home, which is adorable, and this is why I love Lizzie.
We have a purple bandana. We have this lovely soft pink floral. And this is like kind of Christmassy.
I think that East is beautiful just the way that she is, but we did kind of want to do something special just to make her pop a little bit.
Yeah, let's do the pink one so it's...
Can we do this?
Pink will look good on her.
Pink it is.
I'm so excited to prepare East for her meet and greet. This is such a huge deal. And, you know, the whole staff is rooting for her and can't wait to hear if it goes well. And part of me is nervous, but part of me is very, very excited.
Today, we are going to meet with Jane and Andy from Maryland to meet a dog that they are going to potentially adopt.
Hi.
Hi.
Jane?
Yep, I'm Jane.
I'm Lizzie.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
This is Andy.
I'm Ryan.
Hi,
nice to meet you.
My name's Jane. I came here to get a new companion dog. I brought with me my husband, Andy.
I saw it on Facebook. I saw you guys got flooded somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
This way. Yeah, it was really bad.
It would be Jane's decision more so than mine on the dog because she's home more than me, probably 23 hours a day.
So y'all can sit on the little love seat.
So dogs can cuddle.
Yeah.
Or a dog.
Dog, one dog.
Dog.
What's different about this adoption is that they have come all this way to meet one dog. So for me, it's like if they come here and they meet this one dog and for whatever reason it just doesn't feel right, I don't really know. I don't have a backup plan.
So I guess we'll just start.
We can start with past dogs.
Past experience. Dogs. We've had three dogs. We had a beagle.
We had a beagle, a shepherd chow, and a pit bull.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Lou was our empty nest dog. She's pit bull.
That was your most recent?
Yes. Okay. Swore we'd never have one. Didn't want one.
If you would have asked me, 10 years ago if I would get a pit bull, I would have said, under no circumstances, from everything I heard, but she was the best dog we ever had. She literally was the best dog we ever had. She wanted to be on your lap all the time. She was, she slept in bed with us. She went on vacation with us. She was just like a lap dog.
She was supposed to be with us for 2 weeks. She ended up with us for 6 years. We got her when she was maybe 5 to 6. She ended up with breast cancer.
Jeez.
So we had to put her down a couple months ago.
I mean, it's the right time for us because I have stage 4 cancer. Now I'm technically in remission. So the tumors are still there, but they're not reproducing.
I'm home all day. He works Monday through Friday.
I work day work.
Yeah.
Okay.
with Jane being retired. We got plenty of time.
I was gonna say, you guys have the ideal life for a dog so far.
Yeah. I get treatments every 3 weeks. So every 3 weeks I'm kind of in bed for 4 or 5 days. And I like the company. I miss talking to somebody, and that's pretty much who I talk to, the dog.
We looked around different places, you know, pit bull rescues and SPCA and all those places. And, you know, I was up one night not feeling good, and I just went on your website. And
you had really taken a liking to East.
Yes.
I was really excited about that because not a lot of people, no one's actually ever picked her. We got East after she was hit by a car. She had a really, really rough start at life. One of our employees had found her, and they had offered to foster her through her recovery. And they said that she was such a pleasure to have in their home. And then when we got her, we were like, this little dog is so great. She recovered and blossomed into this amazing dog. She's wonderful with new people. She goes on our volunteer walks. She's great with families and kids. And she's been wonderful, and she's an easy dog. She's pretty low maintenance. She's small.
Mm-hmm. I can go get her while you, if you want to keep telling them about her. Today's just extra special because East is getting to meet the very first person in her entire life that genuinely wants her to spend the rest of her days with them.
You excited? Come here, East.
Look at you.
Hi, East. You gotta say hi.
She doesn't like us. Well, come here, Eastie.
When we first show dogs, let her run around for a second.
She's never been in the Savannah area before.
Hey, Mama. Oh, look at her, Ann.
Being that it was East's first meet and greet, she was all over the place. She really didn't know what to do. It's a lot going on. She doesn't know that there's people here to meet her that may take her home, so she's just exploring the whole gazebo, trying to go into the play yard, looking for treats. So I'm like, oh gosh, please still love her, please still love her, please still love her.
Hi.
No, I already know you.
Don't glance on your ears now.
You don't have to impress me, I already love you. There you go.
You can come in with me?
You're so distracted.
It's overwhelming for them when they meet somebody new and they see the same people every day. Some adopters get put off when the dog doesn't immediately jump in their lap, but Jane and Andy understood that this is overwhelming and new.
Come on. You can give them the furniture at home. We like dogs on furniture. Come on.
She may have never been on a couch yet. Let's see if she'll get up.
She'll be sleeping in bed. You're going to be sleeping in bed? Well, come over to me.
And they started scratching her and petting her, and she stood right by them, and it was sweet.
Make sure everything's good.
Got no tail.
Smile.
Got no tail. He's a good girl.
Your little nose.
She's all right. I'm done. She's smiling.
Jane lit up, and I'm happy to see Jane happy. Really, that's good enough for me.
And there's no pressure if you're, you know. If you guys tell us today, like, you know, we're going to change our mind.
No, we're not changing our mind.
Oh, okay.
Oh, so wait, this is it. We're done?
She's already in here.
We're already done.
We're done.
Okay, I'm not mad.
She's already on there.
I mean, I wasn't sure if you were going to come meet her in person, and then it happened.
East met every expectation. I just loved her. I just loved her. I don't understand why nobody would want her.
She's never had her own people. You know, no. She sees us every day, but and goes from person to person based off whoever is taking care of her that day. Everyone's going to be so excited for her. I don't think anyone thought that this day would come for her. She just wants a family and a person. East will love that. And the fact that she will have her own people all to herself is a dream come true for her. If the home check goes well, then we will leave her to Jane and Andy, and this is the only chance she's had up until this point. So this has to happen. This has to work out.